And as part of our Commitment 2012 coverage here on News 8, we're profiling each of the U.S. Senate candidates who will be on the June 12th primary ballot. We're beginning with the Democrats, and our News 8's Paul Merrill joining us live right now from the studio with more on this profile. Paul, good evening.
Thanks, Norm. Tonight we're profiling Cynthia Dill. She's 47 years old and lives in Cape Elizabeth with her husband and their two children, educated at the University of Vermont and Northeastern Law School. Dill works primarily as a civil rights attorney. She serves in the state Senate in Augusta and wants her next step to be Washington.
No, I was part of this task force.
Cynthia Dill got into this race for the same reasons that prompted Olympia Snow to decide she wanted to leave the United States Senate.
What we really need are people to get down there and have the political courage to move forward on policies in the face of this small insurgency that's trying to really put the brakes on democracy and progress.
You like the white?
This civil rights attorney and state lawmaker from Cape Elizabeth says there are plenty of good ideas in Washington, and one thing that would help push those ideas along is a Democratic majority.
Sure, partisanship is a problem. But really, the problem that Democrats have is that we just need the votes to move the country forward.
If elected, Dill says her priorities will be to work toward making our tax structure more fair and simple, reducing our military spending, and improving our nation's health care system.
The Affordable Care Act is not perfect. I would certainly work to strengthen it, but I don't think its cost, compared with the cost of doing nothing, is a problem.
Dill has served as a state lawmaker since 2006, first in the House and now in the Senate. She touts her work on securing funding to bring broadband internet to rural parts of Maine. She has no foreign policy experience, but thinks we need to be more careful about how we involve ourselves in overseas affairs.
I'm a big believer in diplomacy and working with other countries and our friends and allies and working collaboratively to solving some of the challenges that are around the globe, but I do not believe that America should be the global police force.
And Dill shrugs off criticism that she's too far to the left to win a statewide race here in Maine.
My record of accomplishment, I think, speaks more about what would help small business and families than sort of judging me based on some stereotype that the Republicans keep spinning that I'm some kind of liberal. I'm not.
We'll be profiling one candidate a night for the next 2 weeks. Tomorrow, Democrat Matt Dunlap. He spent years working as a state lawmaker and Maine's Secretary of State, but he's still relatively low on the name recognition list. What he has to say about that coming up tomorrow night at 6. Live in the studio, I'm Paul Merrill, News 8.